different than any of the previous ones you guys had?
Not the exact same, but for previous years, it felt a lot better because we competed with them. We showed them that we can compete. We see our finish, but a loss is a loss. There's still a lot to look forward to. We have about 5 games left. And we're not going to let Alabama beat us twice. So.
What do you feel like you guys did well in the back end?
Yeah, we communicated well. We flew to the ball. We had some missed tackles, but we had each other's back when we did. They broke one tackle. They had 2 other guys right there waiting to make the tackle.
What about that after that first drive? It seemed like there was a lot of missed tackles in that first drive. How did you guys kind of
rework it? We just made adjustments, simple adjustments. We saw what they were trying to do to us. They had a good game plan. We had smart players where we could adjust our game plan to fit what they were trying to do.
What were the adjustments when you did it?
We just saw certain formations they were trying to get in, so it changed our formation, clicked it off. We saw where they were trying to isolate certain people on our team, so we got some safety up over now.
Brian, it seemed like you had a pretty good read on the interception. Was that something you've seen on film? Did you just kind of see his eyes on that play or how
that? No, it's just something we practice all week. I show like I'm in the middle of the field. Justin Martin had a great reroute for me, slowed up the route a little bit. Saw the quarterback get his eyes over there, and I think it was a good play.
Brian, as a leader on this team, is there anything you can say to Aaron Medley? Obviously, no one wants to be in that position.
Oh, yeah, he's got to keep his head up. We win together, we lose together. If he would have made those kicks, we would have won together. We just lost the game, so can't put any blame on him. We're one team, so there's no blame. No one's pointing the finger.
Brian, you said we have to make sure that Alabama doesn't beat us twice. I think was your wording. How do you do that as one of the leaders on the team moving forward?
Got to stay positive. Loss is loss. You're going to feel bad regardless. But you got to make people see the bigger picture. So they made some outstanding plays on us. They made a couple more plays than we did.
Those 2 catches they had on that last 4-quarter drive, is that you just kind of tip your hat
and play? Yeah, it was great coverage by our corners. They had them locked up pretty good. They just made the play.
Justin got a lot more reps than that corner. Can you kind of assess how you felt like he did?
Well, he did great. He earned those reps. He earned them in practice, through camp. He got hurt early in camp, so it's kind of set him back a little bit. He's been showing up every day at practice, knowing the game plan, very smart, picking up defense very fast. So that's probably why he got more reps there.
Right now, faced a lot of good running backs. Is Henry different than some of them? It looks like he's just hard to keep up the ball.
Yeah, he's definitely bigger, like 245 or something like that. So he's probably one of the bigger running backs. He's right up there with all the running backs we've been facing, one of the better running backs in the nation.
Brian, you guys had a couple of stops in Alabama. I think it got inside the 10 around the 10-yard line. How big were those plays keeping the game close to the offense?
That was great. Goal line stand against Alabama. That's definitely a positive point for our defense to look forward to carrying the next week.
That's it. Thank you. Thank you, Brian.